Yes.
Good. Now, let's make the calculations. We know that we have a flow of water which is 7 kilograms per hour, or 7 liters per hour. I am sorry, this is in European, but I must use European to be very precise, because I have all the, I have to calculate the conversions, but I am pretty sure that your audience will understand. In any case, 1 liter is about 1/4 of gallon, and 1 kilogram is about 2.2 pounds, about. But let me go ahead in kilograms and liters to be extremely precise when I make the physical calculations, because the specific heat is related to matrix. So now we have a vaporization heat, is exactly the vaporization heat, yes, is exactly 615.6 watt hour per kilogram. This means that to vaporize, to convert, to turn into steam 1 kilogram of water, I need 615.6 watt hours. As you have seen, we have a flow of 7 kilograms per hour. So, how many watt hours am I producing now to steam up 7 kilograms of water? I will have energy produced time 7, which is 4309.2 watt hours per hour, because I have 7 kilograms of water per hour, okay? Plus, I have a delta T, because I have to heat up the water from 25, the delta T is 100.1 Celsius less the temperature of inlet of the water, which is 25.3. So the delta T is 100.1 less 25.3, 100.1 minus 25.3 equals 74.8 watt hour per hour, because the specific heat of water is 1, because the specific heat of water is 1, means 1 kilocalorie per kilogram per Celsius degree. At this point, I will have this is not watt hour, but this is kilocalories per hour. Sorry, kilo calories per hour, because is 1 kilocalorie per kilogram per Celsius degree.
Let's take one break, and could you do me a favor so I can see it more clearly? Can you rewrite that up here?
Of course.
Really clearly.
Absolutely. Now, since 1 kilocalorie is equal to 1.14 watt, I will have 74.8 kilocalories equals 74.8 time 1.14 time 1.14 equals 85.2 watt hour. Therefore, the total energy produced is 4,000. Loro usano la virgola al posto del punto, lo sai. 4,309.2. I forgot to make 85.2 time 7, because we have 7 kilograms that have been delta T'd from 25.3 to 100.1. So this is equals 85.2 per 7, 596. Plus 596 time 9, which is equal to 4309.2 4906.1. This is the energy that we are producing.
Net
output energy. The net input is this, is the one that we said before. Now we go to the we remake. This is energy produced, not consumed. Produced, which is 4,906.1 watt hour per hour. Okay? This is the energy produced. Now let's return to see the energy that I am consuming. Alle 11. Beh, sono appunto al dentista prima. We have to measure the energy that we consumed. The energy that we consumed is 3.5 amperes. You see 3.5, this is an amperometer. So, since, now remember this number, 3.5 amperes, and follow me. So we said that the energy consumed is 3.5 amps time for the ohm equation, 220 volts, because in Italy we have 220 volts in our grid for this kind of utilization, which makes a total energy amount of 220 times 3.5 makes 770 watt hour per hour. Now, attention, because this is the clue. We are producing 4,906.1 watt hour per hour, while we are consuming 770 watt hour per hour. If we make a ratio and make 4,906.1 divided by 770, the watt hour per hour that we are producing divided by the watt hour per hour that we are consuming, we have a ratio of 4,906.1 diviso 770 fa 6.37. This is the factor of multiplication of the energy produced respect the energy introduced. And this is why we are here, and this is why we think that this technology is useful. This is a very important spectator. He is Professor Focardi. Is right my calculation?
Questo no, però.
Che cosa?
4 diviso 700.
No, è 4.000. In America la virgola è un punto. Questo è 4.000, punto. In America si usa la virgola al posto del punto e il punto al posto della virgola. Questo è 4.906.1 wattora per ora che abbiamo prodotto, diviso 770 wattora per ora, che fa 6.37. Chiaro?
Quindi questo è il punto.